I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. I apologize for my awful singing. Yeah. Hey guys, welcome back to some more Lego Star Wars The Complete Saga. In the last episode, we started episode 1, The Phantom Menace, and hopped our way on to Naboo by stowing away on an MTT. In this episode, we're going to be meeting a certain character. Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Chapter 2, Invasion of Naboo. The Trade Federation has launched a full-scale attack on this peaceful world of Naboo. Hiding aboard the landing craft, Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan Kenobi have secretly hitched a ride with the invasion force. Now they must make contact with local forces before it's too late. Yeah. I'm not exactly looking forward to this either, guys. Alright, so let's get this out of the way. I'm not the biggest fan of Lego Star... I'm not the biggest fan of The Phantom Menace. I'm glad we're getting the bad ones out of the way first. But... yeah. Sorry, I just instinctively attacked that guy because based on his species, because if you know anything about Star Wars... Okay, up there, you see that target? We can't do anything about that right now. We are Jedis, so both characters we have are Jedis who can't do anything about that right now. Come on, get the heart, get the heart. Alright. So... Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, came out in 1999, I think, yeah. The anticipated, you know, prequel trilogy to the original Star Wars, it was not met with reception well. Let's see, how do I... Imagine the most overconfident director being so confident to the point where he scraps the entire team that was holding him back to make the passion project he wanted to make. That's not a good start. That is not a good start. This led to... oh. Okay, what I should have done was jump on it to then get this, but no, I'm an idiot. So yeah, I think that's how you get the other mini kit, though you can come back with a certain character. Okay, there we go. But there's also another mini kit right there. See, not even Liam Neeson wants him nearby. Look, they're chasing after him to kill him. This is Jar Jar Binks. And unfortunately, has the good ability of triple jumping. But he can't attack. He is completely useless. And we're stuck with him for the rest of this sort of, you know, not just level, but for the rest of this sort of, you know, movie part. There's maybe one or two levels where he's not in it, you know, of in this movie's levels, but more often than not, he's going to be part of your main team. You can tell I don't like Jar Jar Binks. Let's go into the reasons why. He's annoying. He's too focused on comedy when he's not actually funny at all. He is blatantly a racist stereotype. Okay, I can't even go. Oh god, what happened to the frame rate for a second there? Computer, can you not handle a PS2 game? Okay. We'll bring that out. Okay, cool. And the problem is, for quite a lot of puzzle solving like this, you need him. Over there, you have a bounty hunter switch, which is basically similar to your droid switch, except only bounty hunters can access these areas. And yes, I did just read that from the screen to explain it. Hearing those screams are both a curse because they're so annoying, but a pleasure to hear because it's him screaming to his death. Oh. Okay. Oh god, my hand's getting cramped. I wish I had my controller. Oh, guys, just for a moment, work with me. Yeah, the AI is pretty dumb. Okay, there we go. There's another mini kit. Can I say when I first played this, I tried to get that without building the bridge, you know, thing. I got it! After losing all my money. Oh, my hand. Oh my god, duh, what is happening up with this frame rate right now? Okay. Alright, you see this over here, this silver object? We can't do anything about that. We need a high-powered machine, rocket thing, or whatever. I want Liam Neeson. You know, I am actually just going to go into the character creator and make Liam Neeson. I will find you. And I will kill you. What am I... Oh, it could be cool to make Ra's al Ghul. Also, when... Because, you know, it's, you know, upgraded and, you know, that your lightsabers will do perfect reflections when you have, you know, the upgrade or whatever. No! Jar Jar, you fucking frick. No, don't fall off again. Don't. I have no idea what any of this is, but... Yeah. Did you see that awesome force push I did with all those droids? Okay, why am I dropping force studs now? Instead of the standard one? Ugh, this scene. So yeah, we Jedi mind tricked our way to get this ship. Yeah, I thought this level was longer. I did say last episode that I thought this level was longer. I might play the next level. Where's the next level? Level 3. Oh, I'm trying to remember what it is. It's not the pod. That's later on. You know what? I'll continue the story. I've got time, and sure, we can have a half an hour episode. Doesn't really matter. Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Chapter 3, Escape from Naboo. The Gungan leader's boss, Nass, has refused to help the people of Naboo. Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan Kenobi have left his underwater city for the royal palace Red? As the Trade Federation battle droid seize control of Naboo Capital City, Queen Amidala and Captain Punka, her royal protector, are powerless to repel the invasion. Just using, you know, a super repel. They're quite cheap. Oh, I think I know what level this is. I love that! This is just a little sigh. It's like, many of my people are dead right now thanks to this invasion. Our plan is going to be fully taken over. Huh. Huh. So now we are actually playing as a new person. We are now playing as the gun characters. Princess Amidala and Captain Plunka, I think his name was. So you can rapidly hold the button to home in. And I swear you're meant to be able to dodge as well. Hi. Hi, would the actual ability thing like to happen? No, no, don't home on those. Home in on the bloody droids. You're only supposed to kill the bloody droids. So, yeah. New thing, because we have a gun we can shoot, of course. But we can also grapple, which is pretty awesome. We can also punch, which is, you know, pretty good. If we had a Jedi, we could do that. But we don't have a Jedi. Yeah, I knew Sank was here. I think this is actually the way you're meant to go, but, you know, shut up. I thought it might have been a secret or whatever. Okay. Alright. So there we go. Okay. Hi. Amidala. So, here we have block-pushing physics, and they're not exactly the best. Oh my god. Most of the time, you're going to be fighting your own momentum at this point. Or, the fact that you're probably dumb enough to think that... No... You're also fighting your own logic. Yeah. These are switched. I had that there. Yeah, listen to that great sort of fuzzy it just goes... Fuzzy, like, you know, it had a really bad microphone. I can't really speak now, can I? Right. And then I realise I can't even finish this puzzle because I need Dark Force energy and the ability to destroy silver objects, and the gate was open the entire time. Yay. That one always got me when I tried to 100% this game. See, that's how you're meant to do it. I didn't even move at all in that. I was just mashing the button and that's how you do it. And that's how you do the targets. I don't know why, but those green things are so satisfying to kill or destroy. I don't know why. Maybe it's because it's an upcoming thing later on about shooting all of them, but I have no idea why, but it's so satisfying. Look at that little spin on the spot. Alright. Okay, come on, Planker. Come on, Planker, you wanker. About half of the American audience doesn't even know what a wanker is. It's a British term to rub yourself off. It's a person who rubs themselves off often. Even though I wanted to get True Jedi in every level, because we're doing a two level in one, like one video, I do want to sort of, not exactly rush this, but, you know. Just sort of get a sort of move on, as if it would. So there's the exit right there. Just gonna unlock all these hidey holes. As you see, that one's made of silver, meaning we can't do jack. Not even Liam Neeson can. And they did all that without breaking any of their legs. I know they're made of plastic, but, you know, still other stuff seems to be able to destroy them easily. Ooh, that's such a nice looking ship in Lego. I wish I had like a shiny set like that. What if they released that? I don't know. Panaka, that's it. Not Panka. Panaka. Yeah. We didn't really do that much this level. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this. If you liked it, leave a like. Let me know what I could improve on, but also tell me, what's your favorite Star Wars movie? Tell me down in the comments below what your favorite is, and I will see you next time. For the Mos Espa Pod Race. I'll see you guys then.